Alright guys, we're back in the garage for another video. If you're new to the channel, I use these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments related to the B58 and S58 community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in videos like that, be sure to subscribe. There will be a lot more coming out in the future. So today we're going to be talking about a new intake manifold solution that's just announced to be coming to the market. I actually heard about this a little while ago and I was pretty excited to share it with you guys. I know lately I've been mostly talking about different turbo upgrades and intake manifold upgrades, so I wanted to wait for something a little more innovative before I create more videos like that, and this one is definitely going to bring something new. So the one that we're talking about is coming from Remnant Performance. They're pretty new to the BMW market, and they're pretty exciting with some of the development that they've announced, and this intake manifold is no different. It's actually going to be called the Gamma System, and it's going to have two different stages. Stage one is going to be a typical port injection plate, so pretty much something we're all familiar with. This is going to help you super guys get past your fuel limits of the stock direct injection fuel system. So it's going to add 6,050cc Bosch injectors into the port injection plate that mounts between your intake manifold and the cylinder head, and that way you should be able to support upwards of 1,000 wheel horsepower on full E85 and even more on race gas. So this is something that's been tried and true. A lot of people have different fuel system upgrades like this, but the difference with the Gamma system is there's also a stage two portion that adds an upgraded intake manifold. This intake manifold is going to come with a larger core. It's going to have larger connections for the intercooler so that you can flow as much coolant through there as possible to optimize your heat transfer. And the real benefit here is that this two-stage system can actually mount together. So you will not need to sell your port injection plate. The intake manifold is actually designed to mount just like the stock intake manifold would mount to a port injection plate. So they looked at the overall design and geometry of how much space they would have, optimized the size of the core and all of the fittings to make all of the connections, just like the stock intake manifold, and you can buy these two systems separately. So the real cool thing here is if you already have a port injection plate and you're looking at upgrading to an intake manifold, you can just buy the stage two portion. It'll mount to pretty much any port injection plate on the market, just like the stock manifold, at a much cheaper price, and you won't have to worry about trying to sell your port injection plate to upgrade. So I think this is really cool to see because, of course, it addresses two of the big issues, fueling as well as cooling, but it also helps attack one of the bigger issues that a lot of us are concerned about, being the high price of intake manifolds. And at the end of the day, they're all pretty competitive against each other. I haven't seen any more than like a $500 difference between the different options on the market. But the ability to keep your current parts and just upgrade to the stage two portion is a nice option to have. And of course, if you have started from scratch, you can also buy their stage one portion until you're ready to upgrade the intake manifold as well. So both of them fit together, but also the stage two is designed to fit with any other port injection plate. Now, there are a couple limits that come with this. So first of all, it is only designed for the Mark V Super at this time. The Super intake manifold is different than the Gen 1 intake manifold, so we'll see in the future if they're able to develop one for Gen 1 fitment as well. Also, I saw some people asking if they could just buy the Stage 2 portion because they have no plans of adding port injection to their car, but they still want the benefits of increased cooling at a lower price point. And unfortunately, it doesn't seem like that's going to be an option. The way that the intake manifold was designed is with the port injection plate in place. So they optimized the intake manifold intercooler position and size based on the other accessories that run underneath the intake manifold, like the alternator and the wiring and all of the coolant hoses and things that have to run underneath it. So because of that, if you don't have a port injection plate there, then it's actually going to mount the intake manifold lower, and that will cause it to crash with some of the other components. So basically, they can't guarantee that it will fit without the port injection plate. You can get it and just block it off and not run it into your fuel system so that it'll just be an extra sealed component, but that's just kind of a limitation that you should keep in mind. So as always, we'll want to wait for this to come to market. They did say that it's starting production now, so hopefully in the next couple months we'll actually see it for sale, and then we'll wait to see some data and hopefully it performs as well as it seems it should. I think with the bigger core, they really are on the right track with it. It also will come with a phenolic spacer, which we're learning is even more important with these intake manifolds that have the integrated intercooler if we want it to be efficient. So time will tell, but I just wanted to help put this on you guys' radar. You guys can follow their social media, and they frequently post updates to their stories as well as their social media pages so that you can see the latest and greatest news. So yeah, I think that's about it for this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave it down below. Do 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 do